about to leave. Already packing, come with me. I'm not really asking. We'll get away to a place where we don't know.
Hey guys, and welcome back to another video on my channel. In this video, we are talking about the TNTINA'S trial challenges. That is a mouthful, but so today at either 1 PM GMT or 2 PM GMT, I'm not too sure what one it is, challenges will unlock called TNTINA'S trial. They are the first part to unlocking the ghost or shadow variant of TNTINA. And yes, you did hear me correct, the first part. There are two parts. You've got to complete 18 out of the 20. Each week, 10 challenges unlock. So altogether, you've got to complete basically 2 weeks worth of challenges for getting one on each week or two on whatever. So the challenges will be on screen now with timestamps next to each challenge. So if you only want help with the one challenge, you can then skip ahead in the video at that timestamp to find out when we talk about that one challenge. So you don't have to watch the whole video to just figure out one single challenge, because I don't want to keep you guys waiting. You guys want to get complete challenges and get your tiers. So let's jump on to the first challenge. The first challenge is eliminate players using explosives, and you've got to eliminate 5 players. Explosives being explosive RPGs, C4s, grenades, and the new proximity mines are actually in the explosive category. I don't know if they will count or not, but if you go hover over them, they do count as the as an explosive weapon or item. All of them will be on screen now, so you can see. And also, I don't know if TNTINA's tanks that you can pick up and throw, I don't know if they count or not. They might not. We'll have to wait and see when challenges unlock if it just counts. But C4s are quite common to find. Grenades are common, so they are quite common to find. RPGs are a bit harder to find, but they're still not the rarest thing anymore. And the new proximity lines are a rare rarity. I've been into 2 games and I've got 6 of them plus in each game. So they're not that rare, but they're not the easiest to find. So yeah, once again, that is 5 limbs with any of them. The next challenge is search chest at Holly Hedges or Retail Row. Once again, Holly Hedges and Retail Row, there will be a map on screen with chests over locations. Holly Hedges, Retail Row, they're not that hard to find. All you have to do is open up your map and you can see. You've got to search 10 chests, which is quite a lot, but both locations have a lot more than 10. I think Holly has something like 12, and Retail has, I think, something like 15 or something. But yeah, so you don't have to do them all in one location. You can spread them out wherever you can land. But yeah, so that's another challenge. The third challenge is destroy structures with pro-prone, I think that's pronounced, tanks. That is 10 structures with what they are. They are the tanks that you pick up that are TNTINAs. I think they are only found at the rig, I'm not too sure. But yeah, all you have to do is pick one up and throw it at a build. Yeah, I don't think it has to be enemies. I think it can be any structure, because normally it would specify destroy opponent's structures, but it doesn't say that. So I'm not too sure on that one until the challenges come out. And obviously, as of recording this, they're not out yet. But yeah, just pick up tanks and start lobbing them at builds, and it will eventually count for something. The fourth challenge is catch air with a motorboat. 0 out of 5. I think that's seconds. 5 seconds, I'm guessing. And how you catch air is literally just drive a motorboat off of any sort of high building, structure, waterfall. There's, you've got the dam just next to, what is it called, Slurpee Swamp. You've then got the waterfall next to, what's it called, Lazy Lake. And then you've got the bigger waterfall up a bit from Lazy Lake. So you can drive it off any three of them. You can build up and drive it off that. You can drive it off a cliff that's a bit in the air. But yeah, so it's not that hard. I do also have a clip of how you can do it on screen. It's not that hard. So yeah, the next challenge is visit different landmarks. And that is 15. So that is not a little amount. You've actually got to visit 15 landmarks. There are quite a few of them. I'll have an image of all of them on screen now. I think there may be a couple more because that image was made in season 1, chapter 2. So I think a couple more got added. Some of them may got removed, but they're pretty much near enough all still the same. The next challenge is use upgrade bench to side grade a weapon. That is not that hard. All the side grade benches will be on screen now. Don't forget, you've got to side grade a weapon, not upgrade. So I think you've got to have an AR and side grade it to a heavy AR. And that is 0 out of 3. So you've got to do that 3 times. I'm pretty sure it can be done in the same game. It doesn't say if you can or not. But yeah. The next challenge is deal damage to bosses, 0 out of 500. So that's 500 damage. The bosses are, you've got Sky at the shark, you've got Meowsicles at the yacht, you've got Midas at the agency, you've got TNTina at the rig, and of course you've got Brutus at the grotto. All them locations will be on screen now with all the bosses as well. I'm pretty sure they have something like 200 to 300 health, or something around that. So I'm pretty sure it will have to be done in 2 games. They might even have 500, but I know they have a lot more than 200. The next challenge is land at the rig, Hydro 16, and Logjam Woodworks. All three of them are at the bottom left of the map. They are all quite close. In Team Rumble, it is possible to do it in the same game. But yeah, so I will have an image on screen now with a glider symbol over all locations, so you know where they all are. The next challenge is destroy sentry cameras or sentry turrets. Hint at this one, you got to destroy 5. The cameras only have 50 health, so they were one hit. The turrets have 1,000 or something like that. They're a lot more harder to break, the turrets, than the cameras. So if you want to do this challenge quick and easy, destroy the cameras. They are at all of the bosses' locations, and there's also a location east of Weeping Woods. I'll put an image on screen now of all of them. There might be a couple more scattered around the map here and there, but they're the main locations where they are. And the final challenge is eliminate players without using shield or healing items in between eliminations. And you've got to get two eliminations without healing, health or shield. You cannot drink any sort of shields or consume any sort of healing items at all while you get the two elims. So that is probably best in Team Rumble if you're not that good at the game. Because you cannot heal. So if you're left on 1 HP, you've then got to try and get an elimination on that 1 HP. If you are left on 100 HP and 100 shield, then you've got to get an elimination on 100 HP, 100 shield. So yeah, it's not that hard of a challenge, but for some people it will be quite difficult. So, they are all 10 challenges. From them 10 challenges, you can get 5 tiers with no XP left over, as each challenge gives you 40 XP, 2 challenges giving you 1 tier. So, yeah. Once again, I don't think we will be able to unlock TNTINA's upgrade, the Ghost or Shadow variant, this week. I'm pretty sure we waited until next week until we can unlock that. I will have a video out next Thursday talking about the next week's worth of challenges. So I will see you guys then. If you did enjoy it, leave a like, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.